Good morning, all. First of all, I apologize about my English. My English is not perfect. So I ask you to be really indulgent with me. It is my first lecture in English, my first. I've never done this before. Today, I'm going to talk about the critical path method. It's something to deal with project management. Okay, I've done this in French already, and many persons asked me if I could do it in English. So today, I'm going to try the best I can. I'll do my best to explain, to try to put forward this method, which is really, really easy. It is difficult to build up a network, but using two steps, I'm going to try to explain. You must be all able to build what we call a critical path network using this method. If I manage to make myself understood by most of you, I'll try to do the same thing with the PERT program evaluation review technique, or program evaluation research task. So let me try, and slowly but surely we might be able to understand what am I trying to put forward. But I ask you again not to be kind enough to forgive my spelling, or my accent, which is not a good accent in English, but I'll do my best to make my speech understood by you. Okay, let us start. First of all, I'm going to build a network. I'm going to stop the video, build a network, show you the final result, and I'll wipe the board, and we're going together trying to reach that goal by using two steps. I don't want to go deep inside to the project, how the project is built and everything. Maybe all this stuff is, you know, all these things. I mean, if you intend to build a building, you're going to to structure your project with activities. Each activity has a duration, but you know that you cannot begin an activity unless there are dependencies between activities. For instance, you cannot put on the electricity if you have not yet built the walls. You understand? So there are you've got to try to fulfill certain conditions. So let me stop the video, draw a network on the board, and explain every items. And after that, I'm going to develop in front of you what I call I like this method because it's really simple to put forward. Okay, let's start. Well, here's my network. So what you can see here There are one, two, three, four, five, six activities. So if you read, if you have a look here, you've got. I've done this on purpose. I mean, I didn't list the activities in alphabetical order. That's the reason why I call this activity A, and this one is called D, and this one is called B. No matter, because when you start a project, when you've got a project, what you do is you list all your items, all the activities you're going to fulfill to achieve this project. Once you've done this, you're going to see, you're going to codify each activity. Look, each activity will be replaced by a letter. For instance, if you're trying to build a building, the one activity is to look. It is to look to try to find the architect. This activity might be take the place for the letter B. Look for an electrician. This activity might take the letter maybe A. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter the way the how do you say the. How you arrange the activities. What is important is that you master the project. You know that before building a wall, you must dig. Before painting, you must build a wall, etc. All those things, you know that. So what you do is you list all the activities, and after that, I'm going to explain to you how you're going to achieve something that looks like this. How can this be read? What lecture do you have of this network? This network tells us there is a start point and there is an end point. I'm going to start here, I'm going to finish here. Each activity is underlined by a letter. Letter B stands for something. Letter E stands for another thing. I mean, when I say something is an activity, letter E stands for another activity. What you can see from this network is that the C activity, cannot start. The C activity can start at only one condition. The C activity can start only if activity A and activity D is finished. In other words, C depends, there is a dependency, depends on A and D. In other words, C cannot start unless A and D are finished. This is shown by these arrows. Above each arrow, there is a figure. 8, 4, 2, 9. This number stands for duration. This number stands for duration. Means the A activity has a duration of 8 days, 8 months. It doesn't matter a unit. It's 8 days. Let's say 8 days to make it simple. For instance, the activity E, its duration is 5 days. The activity D, its duration is 4. That's the reason why we've got 4 here and 4 here. That's the reason why we've got 2 here and 2 here. Okay, try to make the slowest explanation I can. Okay, because I've been here and there, and I think it's rather messy the way things are explained. So I'm trying to do it in English, because people asked me long ago, and every time, can you please do it in English, because we do not speak French. So I say, well, not today. Okay. Here, I've got a legend here. This place is for activity. F, D, E, B, B, C, etc. Here, it's what I call, here is the start time. Here stands for the earliest start time. Here, it's for the latest start time. Earliest start time, latest start time. If I have time, I can even go further and add another two boxes here. So here, I'll keep the activity. And here, I can, instead of having the start, I have the finish time. And here, instead of having the start, I have the finish time. And here, I can say the earliest finish time. And here, I can say the latest finish time, okay? Earliest finish time, latest finish time, okay? Yeah. So, now that you beginning to understand, at least make a lecture of what's on the board, I'm going to explain to you how again this can be read. Before starting activity E, all the activities before E must be finished. In other words, the predecessors. I don't know if my predecessors of E are F, C, D, and A. The predecessors of C are A and D. The predecessors of F is only D. You understand now? I'm gonna I don't know the word for efface, to wipe up the board. My English is very well. In 1976, I've left Edinburgh in 1976. So from I haven't spoken English since. So my English has I don't want to tell you how old I am, but my English has faded away. I've got some reminiscences of words. So, I think it would be enough to explain what I'm trying to do today. So, let me start again. So now I'm going to explain to you how I shall calculate the earliest start time and the latest start time. The project can begin just now. So here, it's zero. Here, it's zero. You begin like this. There is no duration here. So A can start just now. D can start just now. Okay. Let's place ourselves here, it's easier. Before F starts, D has to be finished. It takes 4 days to achieve D. In other words, the earliest start time for F is 0 plus 4, which is 4. Okay. What is the earliest start time for C? C cannot begin unless there are two conditions. There are two predecessors for C. Activity A and activity D. For C to begin, A and D must be finished. It takes 8 days for A, and it takes 4 days for D. So C must begin the earliest time. It can be either 0 plus 8 or 0 plus 4. You must take the maximum value of the two. The maximum of 8 and 4, naturally, is 8. So C must start the earliest time. The earliest start time for C is 8. How about F? How about B? B can start only if C is finished. 8 plus 2 comes to 10. For E, there are two predecessors for E. There are two arrows, two branches that converges to E. In order that E can start, you must check that both of them, C and F, are finished. It takes 3 days for F. 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. 8 plus 2 is equal to 10. As we said, we take the maximum of the two values. We take the maximum of the two values, which is 10. I've got to choose between 10 and 7. The choice will be 10. Now, here. So let me make it a little bit different, so that we do not end up with the same. Let's put here five, and let's put here 11. Okay, let's put here 11. Okay, so 4 plus 5 is equal to 9, 8 plus 2 is equal to 10. So the maximum of the two is 10. And here, 4 plus 5, I made this on purpose because I didn't want the same value here. Okay, that is 9. It doesn't change anything. Never mind. Let's do it this way. Maybe here I would say, let's leave it this way. Donc, 4 plus 5, 9. 8 plus 2, 10. I'll take the maximum of the two, which is 10. Here, 10 plus 5 is equals to 15. Let's put the 9 as I've written before. 10 plus 5 is equal to 15. 10 plus 9 is equal to 19. So, the shortest time, the duration, the completion of the project will be 19 days. No matter what you do, you will never go under this date. I mean, you need at least 19 days to complete the project. Having said that, does this mean that it will be sure that it will be 19 days? The answer is no, because some of the activities here can be delayed. So if an activity is delayed by 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, the whole project will support that delay. So the aim is to be able to find what we call the critical activities. That means a critical activity is an activity that cannot be delayed. 1 day of delay in this activity will delay the whole project by 1 day. All these activities that are critical activities will be listed, and the path that goes through all these activities is called the critical path. I'm going to explain to you how we're going to find the critical path. Hope I made myself understood. Sorry about the accent, I'm trying to articulate the best I can. Best I can. Okay. Now, how do we find the latest start time? What do? We go from the far end. We write 19. 19. I don't know if the green color is okay. Let's try it with the blue. Is it okay? Well, I don't know. 19. What you do is, you're going to go backwards and subtract. But here, you say 19 minus 5 is equal to 14. I'm going to keep the black color, 14. That means activity E, its earliest start time is 10 days. Its latest start time is 14 days. And I'm going to explain later on, there is a margin. How do you say a total margin? The total margin for E is the difference between the latest start time and the earliest start time. The total margin is 4 days. That means the activity E can be delayed up to 4 days, and this will have no effect on the completion of the project. This will have no impact on the total duration. That means the activity E will not be on the critical path. All right? The activity E will not belong to the critical path. Okay, what time is it? I've got a lecture in less than an hour, so I've got to speed up. Sorry. So let's start again. 19 minus 9, which is 10. Okay. So now there is a difficulty here. When we go this side and we've got two arrows going in, we take the maximum value. On the other hand, when you go backwards and you subtract the duration of the present activity, you take the minimum value. Look here, you've got the choice between 10 minus 2, which is 8, and 14 minus 2, which is 12. here I write 12. It won't, if here I write 12, it's okay with here, but here, 12 plus 2 will give us 12 here, which is not possible. That's the reason why, when you go backwards, you take the minimum value of all subtractions you make. When you've got two or three arrows that go backwards, like here, I've got going this way and I can go this way. So I've got the choice between 10 minus 2, which is 8, and 14 minus 2, which is 12, which is the smallest, 8. So here I put 8. Let's have a look at the activity B. B, the two dates, the earliest and the latest date are equal. That means there is no margin. The total margin is zero. That means B is a critical task, critical activity. Then B belongs to the critical part. The same way with C, the two durations are equal, the earliest and the latest. C belongs to the critical part. Okay, let's carry on. 14 minus 5, that is 9. Do I have two choices? No. Here, once again, I have two choices. It's either 9 minus 4, which is 5, or 8 minus 4, which is 4. Let me start again. 9 minus 4, which is 5, and 8 minus 4, which is 4. We take the minimum value of the two, and the minimum value is 4. Okay? And 8 minus 8 is 0. So, the critical part is A, C, and D. The critical path is A, C, and B. That means if any of these activities is delayed by one day, the whole project will have the same delay of one day. So as a manager, you must as a manager be really careful to achieve these activities on scheduled time. Otherwise, there will be a cost. But you know, time is money. Time is money. So if there is a delay, there are, how do you say, compensation, monetary compensations. So to avoid, how do you say, an hypothetical cost, you must be aware that these activities must be looked very, very carefully and followed very carefully so that you make sure that all the times, the durations, their durations are respected. On the other hand, the activity F can be delayed. There is a, how do you say, margin of total margin of 5 days. The activity E, pareil, is c'est pareil. From my, I'm used to speak French. Sorry. So from time to time, I try to. I must, no matter what happens, never use French. It's a kind of challenge. Maybe I'll be very glad if your comments will help me. So if your comments are go to my side, I will make an effort to treat the same problem, the PERT problem. which is exactly the same, but it's a bit difficult. Okay, it's by the way, I didn't say what date we were, the 3rd of May 2018. Okay, it's the way I start my lectures. I always give the date so that people know how old we are today and how old we'll be in a few years. Okay, now, as I said, I'm going to wipe up this board and explain to you how did I build this. There are two steps I want to explain. There are two steps. First step, we must calculate the levels. I'm going to explain this very, very simply. Levels, because what is possible with a small project like this can be done with a huge project, because this method is really, really simple to put forward. So first step, try to calculate the levels. I'm going to explain to you what it is, just quickly. Here, before A, there's nothing. The predecessor of A does not exist. There is no predecessor for D. So the level one, if I call it like this, level one, the activities that belongs to the first level are A and D. If I go here, the project finishes with B and E. The last level will be the ending activities. But in between, there can be dozens of activities. So we're going to try to say which activities are of level 1, level 2, level 3, etc. So, first of all, try to find the levels. Second step. People never speak about this, but it's very crucial. It's very, very important. I mean, without this, you will do things, how do you say, empirically. I mean, with no method. Okay. The second step is to find the immediate predecessor of each activity. I explain this. The immediate activity of E, the immediate activity, predecessors activities of E are F and C. The immediate, wait, E. Before E, there is F. And before E, there is C. But if I say all the predecessors of E, the list can be long. Here, the predecessors of E are A, D, C, F. I repeat, the predecessors of E are A, D, C, and F. When I build a project, I don't care about immediate predecessors. All I know is I've got to list all the predecessors. And my method will explain to you how to reduce the four predecessors to eliminate E and D, which are redundant predecessors. E and D are redundant because when I say before E there is only C and F is enough. But when I build my dictionary of activities and predecessors, before E I will write A, D, C, and F. And I will explain to you how to get rid of A and D, and to finish with only with C and F. All right? If I look before B, the immediate predecessor of B is C. But the predecessors of B, are A, D, and C. How do I get rid of A and D, which are redundant predecessors? How do I get rid of those two predecessors' activities? That's the second step I'm going to explain. So, my board is very small, and I don't have any way to move my camera around. So what I'll ask you, can you please, on a sheet of paper, reproduce what is here, because I'm going to wipe everything, and I will try to list all the activities and all the predecessors without all the predecessors. Before E, I will write A, D, C, and F. Before B, I will write A, C, and D. Okay? And I'm going to explain to you how I can simplify these predecessors. Okay? So I'll give you 2 minutes to put this down. So I'll write it down here. So do I have enough place? Okay. Here is the activities. Okay, activities. I have A, B, C, okay, D, E, F. Do I have enough? Okay, it's okay. Here, I write all the predecessors. Predecessors of, before A, I have nothing. So here, before A, I have nothing. Before B, what do I have? A, D, and C. Before B, I have A, D, and C. I have A, C, and D. A, C, and D. Before C, what do I have? A, and D. Okay? Before D, what do I have? Nothing. Before E, what do I have? I have all those except B. I have A, B, C, and D. Except E. Before F, what do I have? Before F, I have only D. Okay, before F, I have only D. And for instance, after that, here, I have the duration. Duration for A is 8 days. For B, A, C, and D, sorry, for B, it's 9 days. For C, it's 2 days. For D, is 4 days. For E, is 5 days. And for F, is 5 days. Well, it doesn't matter, it's the same figure. Okay, 14. Okay, does it change something? No, but let's leave it this way. So, here's my project. So, my question is, how from this I end up with this? So, on the start, I have this. In my work finish will look like this. So I'm going to explain to you the two steps. Okay, so I, 1, 2, 3. Hope I didn't make a mistake. Hope everything is okay. A, nothing. B, 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 A, C, and D. D, nothing. E, A, B, and C, and after, before F, only D. Okay. So, allez, c'est parti. So, I'm going to build here. Here it is. A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay? Here are the predecessor activity. Predecessor activities. Before A, nothing. Before B, A, C, D. Before C, A and D. Before D, nothing. Before E, A, B, C, and D. Before F, D. Okay. So, the durations, I write them here. 8, 9, 2, 4, 5, and 5. Okay. Let's wipe this. There we are. So, I'm going to explain to you how we're going to try to list the levels. The method is very simple. You must really follow this method. How do I list the levels? Activities of level 1 are all activities that do not have any predecessors. Very easy to understand. In other words, here I write the level. The activities of level 1 are A and D. A and D. Why? Before A, there is nothing. Before D, there is nothing. There is nothing before A nor D. All right? People say, well, are you left-handed or right-handed? Well, I'm both, actually. It's very easy to write with both hands because it depends where the students are. If I'm looking this way or I'm looking that way. So if I'm looking this way, I use my left hand. If I'm looking that way, I use my right hand, okay? Let's now find the second level. The activities of level 1 are A and D. What you do now is in this column, you eliminate, you never rewrite nor A nor D. Here I've got nothing. I don't put anything after A. I get rid of A and D. I get rid of A and D, I am left with what? I am left with the letter, the activity C. Understand? I get rid of A and D. I get rid of all the activities of level 1. And I get the activities of level 2. Here, I get rid of A and D. I get rid of A and D. If I get rid of A and D, I'm left with nothing. That means there's a bar. Nothing. I got nothing, I write nothing. To make things simple. I get rid of A and D, I'm left with B and C. I get rid of A and D, I'm left with nothing. That means the activities of level 2 add all the activities that have nothing before having eliminated A and D. So the activities of level 2 are are C, sorry, I'll use a write a blue pen, C, N, F. Level 1, A and D. Level 2, C and F. I keep on using this algorithm. Get rid of C and F. If I get rid of C and F, I'm left with nothing. If I get rid of C and F, I'm left with B. That means the activity of level 3 is exactly B. Okay. The activity of letter, level one, or level zero as you wish. You can start at 0, 0, 1, 2, or 1, 2, and 3. So I get rid of all the activities of level 3 to find the fourth level. So if I get rid of B, I get here nothing, which gives me the last level, which is the activity E. So, if you don't mind, I will list here the levels. The levels are listed here. Levels. Level 1, 2, 3, and 4. The activity of level 1 is A and D. Of level 2 is C and F. And of level 3 is B. And of level 4 is E. Do I see it? Okay. A, D, C, F, B, and E. Okay. That is the first step. Step 1, calculate the levels. Here are they. I know that my project will start like this and will finish like this. We'll start with A and D and finish with E. Okay. Now, let me explain to you how I get. Here I've got the predecessors. All the predecessors of each activity. Now, I'm going to explain to you how do I get the immediate predecessor. Immediate, not all. This is very important for building our network. This is very important for building our network. Okay, so let me use the same, because I don't want to draw another board again. I'm going to explain to you how this works. Look. Here, I'll get here, I'll have the final result. Here I get the immediate predecessors. The final result here, I will list all the immediate predecessors for each activity. It's very easy. For A, there is nothing before A. So for A, it doesn't change. Before A, there's nothing. Before D, there is nothing. So, no problem. Before F, there is only D. So the immediate predecessor of F is D. So, in this column, you rewrite all the activities that have nothing before, or only one activity before. And now, I'm going to explain to you how shall I simplify, how will I get rid of all the redundant conditions, the redundant predecessors that are, there is no need to list them here. Here's the method. Let me show you something like this. A, B, and C. D'accord? A, B, and C. If I write the predecessors, here I am, A, B, and C. Okay? Let me write it a little above, because I have not enough room. Here, A, B, and C. Okay? Here, my task activities are A, B, and C. Okay? Here are my predecessors. Okay? Before A, nothing. Okay? Before A, nothing. Before B, A. Before C, A and B. I can add another one if you like. Let me add a fourth one. Let me add a fourth one, which I call D. Let me add a fourth one, which I call D. The fourth activity. Okay? Let's write it this way. And before D, I have A, B, and C. Okay? Here's the method for simplification. Here's the method you can adopt to get all the immediate predecessors. Before A, there's nothing. So I write nothing. Before B, there is A. So I write A. Let me now explain how I, here, if you look at this network, before C, immediately before C, there's only B. Before C, there's only B. That means that the conditions A is redundant. How do I get rid of A? Look, you say, you put your finger here, and you say, before A, what do I have? Before A, what do I have? Nothing. Before A, I have nothing. Before B, what do I have? Before B, I have A. So I write A. And I carry on. I say, before A, what do I have? Nothing. So my question is, here, you look, you see, I have A and B. In this list, I got A once again. So A, the activity A, this condition is redundant. So you get rid of A, and you're only left with B. Let's start with ABC. Before A, what do I have? Nothing. Before B, what do I have? A. Before C, what do I have? A before C. I have A and B. So I've got already A. So I add B. I carry on. Before A, what do I have? Nothing. Before B, what do I have? Nothing. A. And I carry on. Before A, what do I have? Nothing. Look, I started with A, B, C. What are the activities that are listed again? Look, A and B. A and B are redundant. I get rid of A and B. I am only left with C. So before A, there's nothing. Before B, there is A. Before C, there is only B. And before D, there is only C. So I'm going to apply this method to what's on the board here. Look, I try to do it slowly. So what you've got to understand is all the tasks, all the activities that I will list here, I get rid of them. I mean, all the activities from, if I see A here, I get rid of A. If I see C here, I get rid of C, etc. Let's start. Before A, what do I have? Before A, I have nothing. Before C, what do I have? A and D. I mean, really, there's no way of going on. If you look here, you've got E and D. You've repeated E and D. When you get rid of E and D, what do you are left with? What? With C. So immediately before B, there is only C. But you can carry on the process and say, before A, what do I have? Nothing. Before D, what do I have? Before D, nothing. So I repeated A, I get rid of A. I repeated D, I get rid of D. I say that A and D are redundant conditions, are redundant predecessor activities. So I get rid of A and B. In other words, it means what exactly? It means that when I say before B there is a C, it's enough. It includes the fact that before B there is A and D. So, okay, but this is very important for me to build my network, as I'm going to show you later on. Now, let's start here. Before A, what do I have? Nothing. Before D, what do I have? Nothing. Did I repeat A? No. Did I repeat D? No. So I keep A and D. I keep A and D. So immediately before C, there is A and D. So if you look at the chart, if you go back to the video back, you're going to see before C there is E, A and D, and before B there is only C. Immediately before C there is A and D. So let's start now with A, B, C and D. Before A there's nothing. Before B, A, C, D. There's no way to carry on, because if you eliminate A, you eliminate C, you eliminate D, you left with what? You left with B. That means before E, immediately before E, there is B. I can carry on. Before A, there's nothing. Before C, there is A and D. Before D, there's nothing. I carry on. Before A, nothing. Before D, nothing. Well, I repeated E, A, C, and D. I get rid of A, C, and D. I'm left with B. I get rid of A and D. I'm left with C. So avoid crossing the activities, because it's going to be messy. So what my advice is, never for the levels or for finding the immediate activities, the immediate predecessor activities, to avoid to have a messy thing, is to do it gradually like I have explained. So now we've got everything to build our network. So let me please get rid of this and write that before A, here, immediate. Before A, nothing. Before B, C. Before C, A and D. Before D, nothing. Before E, B. And immediately before F is D. There we are. Okay. Now, having this, I can build my network very easily. Well, let me try to find some room, and if you don't mind, I'm going to write my levels here. Do I have enough room here? Yes, I write my levels here, which are AD, level 1, AD. Doesn't look nice. AD, followed by CF, followed by B, followed by E. These are my levels, okay? These are my levels. AD, CF, B, and E. Okay. Let me start my network. First of all, level one is A and D. So, let me write A and D. Yeah. Okay, A and D. So this graph is not as neat as the other one. It just once you've done it on a rough paper, once everything is put manually, you draw rectangles, pretty rectangles like I did at the start. What is important is how can I exploit, how can I get benefit of what I've written down in terms of levels and immediate predecessor activities. Okay? So level one, A and D. Now, let's start with level two. Level two, C and F. Do I put C here? Do I put F here? I can put C here, can put F here, can put F here, and put C here. What do? I take the activity C, and I look and say, which is immediately before C. I look before C, before C. There are both A and D. So C, I can put C here or C here. It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Let's look with F. Let me see which activity is immediately before F. Before F, immediately before F is D. Understand? Immediately before F is D. So, if D is here, you understand, F must be here. Okay. And we say C. Before C, what do I have? Before C, I have A and I have D. There you are. Before C, I have A and I have D. Okay. That is my second level. Let's now move to the third level, which is activity B. A, before A, there's nothing. Before B. Before B, immediately before B, there is C. So B is here. Okay. And the last activity is E. Immediately before E, there is B. I hope I did not make a mistake. In other words, I'm sure there is something missing. Before C, there is A and D. I am sorry. But the trouble is that Let me see what I did before C. Before F, I said A. Before F, I said D, okay. Before C, I said A and D. And before E, I said C and F. Before E, there is C and F. before E, there is, I'm sure I made a mistake. Well, I'm lucky, I just remembered something. Here, there is a mistake here, which is, I'm going to correct. Before E, if you look at the, if you wind up the video, before E, I've written A, C, D, and F. So immediately avant, before E, it's not B. Let me correct this. Here, so I'm going to correct this. So I'll do what I've done before. Once again, before A, what do I have? Nothing. Before C, what do I have? A and D. Okay? Before D, what do I have? Nothing. Before F, what do I have? D. Let's carry on. Before A, nothing. Before D, nothing. So what did I repeat? I repeated the activity A and the activity D. So I get rid of A and D. I get rid of A and D, and I'm left with C and F. That means immediately before E, there is the activity C and F. So let me start again here. The third level is E, and before E, what do I have? I have, let me write the activity, how do you say? Before E, there is C and F, C and F. So I write here, let me take the black color. I write here, how do you say, E. So what do I have? Before E, I have F, and I have C. So here, I got the end. And here, I've got the start. Okay, the end and the start. Okay, so all you have to do now is just draw rectangles, put on here the duration, 8 days for A, 9 days for B, 5 days for E, 5 days for F, how many days for C? 2 days, 2 days for D, how many days? 4 days, 4 days, and afterwards you put here let me draw it rapidly. What do I have? I've got 5 minutes left. Because I wanted to explain to you the third part. Let me just start. Let me draw it very, very small. A, D, okay? D. And C, and etc. Okay, so I'm sorry, but I don't have enough time to carry on. What you do is very, very easy. You just rewind the video and draw exactly the same graph. What I've written here is just you've got to translate it to the first plan I've shown you. But before I carry on, I wanted to explain to you. For instance, if here, let's put the values. I don't remember what values we had, but if I take something like this. If I take something like this, and for instance, my students are waiting outside. If I take something like this, here I've got an activity A. Here, for instance, I've got let's say 5. Here I've got 12, and here the date, the duration is. 5 is 7 days. Here is the start, the earliest start time. Here is the latest start time. If I want the earliest finish time, I just got to add the duration. So 5 plus 7 comes to 12, and 12 plus 7 comes to 19. That means what? That means if 5 is the start, is the earliest start time, 12 is the earliest finish time. To find this number, you just add to the start, earliest start, latest, the duration. Start earliest plus duration equals finish earliest. Start latest, latest start plus duration will give you the finish latest time. Okay? I've got to add 2 things. Here is a network. The activity I, the activity J. Here's the duration of I, D-I-J, the duration. Here is the earliest start time, the latest start time of activity A. I've spoken before about the total margin. The total margin of a task. The total margin of task I is the difference between the latest start time minus the earliest start time. That's the total margin of task of activity I. Now, what does this mean? It means that if the margin, the total margin of an activity is equal to 0, that means that this activity is critical. 1 day of delay of this activity will delay the whole project for 1 day. So the total margin is the delay you can have without any effect on the total completion, on the completion of the project, on the duration of the whole duration of the project. The total margin is the time, the delay you can take without changing the final date. Now I'm going to explain to you what is the free margin of A. Free margin of A. Free margin of A is calculated this way. It's the minimum, because we can have two values coming from here. It's the minimum value of what? Of Tj minus Ti minus the duration between the two. So if I've got here another activity, I'll do the same. And I'll take the minimum value of the two. So this minus this minus this. If you've got something here, you do this minus this minus this, and you take the minimum value of the two. What is the free margin? The free margin is the delay that an activity can take without changing the earliest start time of the following activity. Let's say that the margin, the free margin of I, is 2 days. That means the activity I can be delayed by 2 days without changing this date with no effect to the earliest start time of the next activity. Well, this is the end of my lecture. To be honest with you, it's my first attempt in lecturing in English. I have never done this before. So, there are two possibilities. Either I'm useless. My English is just not a way to lecture. Or if you think that my way of explaining is understood by most of the people that will take the time to see to watch this video. If you think I can help you with other items, please comment. Please let me know, and I'll do my best to try to put forward some of the lectures I've already done in French. I maybe pronounced one or two words in French. Well, I'll say something in French to finish with. Donc voilà, j'ai réfléchi, ça fait pas mal de temps, et c'est vrai que je reçois des mails de personnes qui me disent c'est dommage que vous ne fassiez pas ce type d'explication en anglais. Et donc voilà, j'ai promis à une étudiante qui m'avait demandé justement pour ce sujet-là, il y a deux jours, elle me dit c'est dommage, mais j'aimerais bien que ce cours soit dispensé en anglais. Donc je me suis réveillé ce matin, j'ai répété un peu dans ma tête et j'ai donc essayé de présenter cette séquence. Voilà. Thank you very much indeed. Hope I'll be back among you with another explanation in English, if you wish, that's your will. Okay, take care and bye and see you. Cheers.